Trump sparks internet fury with what was seen poking out of his suit pocket. President Donald Trump once again has the prying eyes of the internet in a tizzy. This time for what he was wearing in his jacket breast pocket, which looked like some kind of foliage. Well, the foliage turned out to be a tradition held since President Harry S. Truman. It was a handful of shamrocks the president wore in order to honor the Irish Prime Minister Taoiseach Varadkar's during his White House visit on Friday. Because what's more Irish than shamrock? Prime Minister Varadkar later presented the president with a traditional bowl of shamrock, which led to both posing for the camera while wearing a pack of shamrocks in both of their pockets. The meeting was the day before St. Patrick's Day. During the meeting, it was revealed that President Trump, who owns a hotel in Ireland, is planning a visit to the country, but no date had been set in the time of the announcement. But of course, the internet was concerned about other things. Of course, no one ever questioned or poked fun at President Obama when he did the same. President Trump said during the meeting that St. Patrick's Day is a time for us to honor and build upon the lasting bonds of our friendship between the United States and Ireland, bonds that have been forged by both nations through a very common heritage, shared values, and a united vision for a peaceful and prosperous future. Today, 30 million people in the U.S. claim to be of Irish heritage. According to Irish legend, St. Patrick, who was the patron saint of Ireland, first chose the shamrock as a symbol of the Trinity of the Christian Church because of its three leaflets bound by a common stalk. Wood sorrel is shipped from Ireland to other countries in great quantity for St. Patrick's Day. History of shamrock, leprechaun, and the Blarney Stone. In written English, the first reference to the shamrock dates from 1571, and in written Irish, as Seamrog, from 1707. As a badge to be worn on the lapel on the saint's feast day, it is referred to for the first time as late as 1681. The shamrock was used as an emblem by the Irish volunteers in the era of Grattan's Parliament in the 1770s, before 98 and the Act of Union. So rebellious did the wearing of the shamrock eventually appear, that in Queen Victoria's time Irish regiments were forbidden to display it. At that time it became the custom for civilians to wear a little paper cross colored red and green. As a symbol of Ireland it has long been integrated into the symbol of the United Kingdom, along with the rose, the thistle and the leek of England, Scotland, and Wales. So today, on St. Patrick's Day, a member of the British royal family presents shamrock to the Irish Guards Regiment of the British Army. The magic shamrock. 3 is Ireland's magic number. Hence the shamrock. Crone, mother, and virgin. Love, valor, and wit. Faith, hope, and charity. Father, son, and Holy Spirit. Numbers played an important role in Celtic symbolism. 3 was the most sacred and magical number. It multiplies to 9, which is sacred to Bridget. 3 may have signified totality, past, present and future, or behind, before and here, or sky, earth and underworld. Everything good in Ireland comes in threes. The rhythm of storytelling in the Irish tradition is based on threefold repetition. This achieves both intensification and exaggeration. Even today in quality pub talk, a raconteur can rarely resist a third adjective, especially if it means stretching a point. 3 accomplishments well regarded in Ireland, a clever verse, music on the harp, the art of shaving faces. The leprechaun. The leprechaun is an Irish fairy. He looks like a small, old man, about 2 feet tall, often dressed like a shoemaker, with a cocked hat and a leather apron. According to legend, leprechauns are aloof and unfriendly, live alone, and pass the time making shoes. They also possess a hidden pot of gold. Treasure hunters can often track down a leprechaun by the sound of his shoemaker's hammer. If caught, he can be forced, with a threat of bodily violence, to reveal the whereabouts of his treasure, but the captor must keep their eyes on him every second. If the captor's eyes leave the leprechaun, and he often tricks them into looking away, he vanishes and all hopes of finding the treasure are lost. Near a misty stream in Ireland in the hollow of a tree. Live mystical, magical leprechauns. Who are clever as can be. With their pointed ears, and turned up toes and little coats of green. The leprechauns busily make their shoes and try hard not to be seen. Only those who really believe have seen these little elves. And if we are all believers, we can surely see for ourselves. Irish blessing. The Blarney Stone. The Blarney Stone is a stone set in the wall of the Blarney Castle Tower in the Irish village of Blarney. Kissing the stone is supposed to bring the kisser the gift of persuasive eloquence, Blarney. The castle was built in 1446 by Cormac Leigh of MacCarthy, Lord of Muskerry. Its walls are 18 feet thick, necessary to thwart attacks by Cromwellians and William III's troops. Thousands of tourists a year still visit the castle. The origins of the Blarney Stone's magical properties aren't clear, but one legend says that an old woman cast a spell on the stone to reward a king who had saved her from drowning. Kissing the stone while under the spell gave the king the ability to speak sweetly and convincingly. It's tough to reach the stone, it's between the main castle wall and the parapet. Kissers have to stretch to their back and bend backward, and downward, holding iron bars for support.